tournament time gets serious. Destination Kansas City now two steps away from reality, as the women's field of 64 is now down to 16. Today, only 8 teams can continue to chase their dreams. Continue our coverage of the NCAA Women's Tournament with the Sweet 16. The Magic is back in Tisha Pinheiro's game as a top seed in the East, Old Dominion, prepares to face Chastity Melvin and NC State. The first of 8 games you can see today and tonight here on ESPN2 and on ESPN. This is our lineup after the NC State ODU game at 2:30 Eastern. We move to the Midwest for Notre Dame and Purdue. Then at 10:30 tonight, it's Illinois and North Carolina. On ESPN at noon Eastern time, Louisiana Tech and Alabama will get after it. Then at 2 o'clock, it's Arizona and Connecticut. Then tonight, 8 Eastern, Rutgers and Tennessee. Folks, you do not want to miss this matchup. Then at 10 p.m., it's Florida and Duke. And our nightcap, Arkansas and Kansas. Logan, everyone, alongside Mimi Griffin and Rebecca Lobo, I'm Robin Roberts. Yes, it's going to be another long day, but it should be an exciting one. We begin with NC State and Old Dominion in the East. NC State has been very impressive in the first two rounds. They haven't made many mistakes, Mimi.
And Robin, for the last 6 games of the season, they played against top 25 opponents. I think that's why they were able to come into the tournament so strong. They have a nice balance of speed and quickness on the outside and power on the inside. Chastity Melvin has established herself as one of the premier post players in the country. Not only is she effective on the blocks, Rebecca, but when they try to double down on her, she leads this team in assists. That's scary if you're her opponent.
I'm gonna tell her that you called her scary just to get her going on you. Old Dominion also has a big physical post player in Nyree Roberts. She will be going head to head with Melvin. And when you get two bangers together like this, officiating becomes that much more important. When you look at the rosters, State goes 8 or 9 deep. Old Dominion plays about 7. And so it's going to be interesting to see how this game is called. And Old Dominion needs Roberts in the game. She played 33 and 40 minutes in the first two rounds.
Something else to keep in mind, Old Dominion has only lost 4 games the last 2 years, 2 to Tennessee, 1 to Connecticut, and the other to NC State. Out to Dayton, Ohio, for Dave Ryan and Doris Burke. We'll see you at halftime.
Robin, thank you. Old Dominion head coach Wendy Larry calls this clearly the most difficult region to win for top-seeded Monarchs to take the first step against 10th-ranked NC State today. Hi, everyone. Welcome to the UD Arena in Dayton. Dave Ryan alongside Doris Burke. And on paper, it's a 1-4 seed. ODU might be a big favorite. But wait a minute. Past success against this team, plus a rivalry exists.
There's a long history between these two schools, Dave. And this senior class from Old Dominion has never beaten NC State. And senior guard Tisha Pinheiro returns. She was named a Kodak All-American a year ago. She played for the national title. But she fell short of her dream, winning it all. She and a significant cast return with their eyes on the prize.
So NC State has a little bit of confidence coming into this game. The problem is their legendary head coach, Kay Yao, has never won a Sweet 16 game.
Kay Yao won Olympic gold as the head coach of the 88 squad. She has 550 career wins, but she's 0-8 in the Sweet 16. And when we asked her about it yesterday, she had to compose herself before she answered. She desperately wants to break through today.
So Doris, the first step toward deciding who gets a shot at Kansas City takes place right now. A double dip from Dayton going on. When we come back, tip off, Lady Monarchs take on Wolfpack next.
ESPN's presentation of the NCAA Women's Basketball Tournament is brought to you by Mercedes-Benz, located on the web at mbusa.com.
Welcome back to the University of Dayton Arena, everyone. Time out of CR. Burt Plus starting lineups as we get set for NC State and Old Dominion. First for the top seed, ODU, bringing in a 10-game win streak. The Colonial Athletic Association champ, deep, very talented, led in scoring and rebounding by senior Nyree Roberts. She says the Lady Monarchs may be even more talented down low this year because Mary Andrade can pop out for jumpers in addition to battle inside. For NC State, the Wolfpack come to the Sweet 16 after wins over Maine and Youngstown State at home in Raleigh. They're led by senior Chastity Melvin. Player Kay Yao credits with turning this program around. She's the team leader in scoring and rebounding, 22 points shy of 2,000 for her career. For State to be successful, Melvin has got to take over this game offensively, Doris.
Oh, she's a power inside, all ACC performer, and she has been there. Not only their best player, but their leader all year long. She's the most experienced. Four NCAA tournament appearances for Melvin, so experience could be critical.
So ready to go. Last year, the teams met early on. That in Norfolk, Virginia, game won by NC State, and a lot of the ODU players have not forgotten the feeling of losing just two games last year. One came to the Wolfpack.
Their only blemish going into the national championship game, and it's something that they haven't let go.
Shepard jumping at center court with Nyree Roberts. NC State controls. Just underway from Dayton. Michelle Jones, double zero. Good score from the wing.
OD opens up in their 2-3 zone. They'll spread you out.
Kristen Gillespie, number 24. She's the junior point guard. Transfer from Auburn. Thinks about a three-pointer. And nails it.
A little surprising that their first bucket comes from a Gillespie. She's a solid point, but not much of a scorer. Capable of shooting the basketball, just prefers to pass it.
Yeah, just 2.8 points a game coming in. Not a lot of offense from her in terms of the points. Andrade posted up. Already she falls on the floor. We're going to see a lot of that. Small's got the rebound.
Straight man-to-man by NC State to open.
Tisha Panichero, of course, runs the show for Old Dominion. Multiple All-American honors. Inside she goes, trying to post up her player. It's out of bounds off of NC State's Chastity Melvin. Fresh 30 for ODU.
Now, NC State has got to be a little bit quicker to the basketball once ODU releases the shot.
Andrade may not have been looking for the inbounds pass. Partially deflected anyway, and comes to Gillespie. Watch out for Panichero on defense. We know she had the 14 steals and a first-round win over St. Francis, an NCAA tournament record. She's very quick.
Now, Big Mimi made an excellent point to start this show. She said NC State's four of six last opponents have been ranked in the top 25. There's going to be no intimidation here.
Two on the shot clock because of the air ball put up by Jones a few moments ago. It's a shot clock violation against the Wolfpack. Chastity Melvin, the senior tri-captain and team leader, calls her players my guards, my forwards. She's really taken over a total leadership role with this team. At first, she didn't want that when she came to Raleigh.
Well, she had some other people ahead of her. Jen Howard, who graduated last year, is the all-time trail leader of the ACC. Tremendous leader.
Aubrey Eplin. She's from a nearby town in Ohio, about an hour and a half away. Misses the three-pointer. Gillespie for Tanisha Lewis. She's on the all-ACC rookie team, number 20, a great slasher. And like Jones, can penetrate from just about anywhere on the floor. Michelle Jones, a bounce pass. Inside Shepard, a bit too hard. But there's Lewis, the freshman, with a left hand. Nice move.
Well, I'll tell you what, NC State lost a lot of guards last year, and freshman Tanisha Lewis, who just got that bucket, has stepped up and filled the void beautifully.
16 points against Maine in a first-round win down in Raleigh at Reynolds Coliseum. 17 and 9 rebounds in a second-round game with Youngstown State. So she's been producing in the NCAAs. No freshman worries there. Here's Roberts, first touch, and she's fouled on the way up.
That's the matchup to watch all game long down there on the blocks. Melvin versus Roberts.
Andy Larry, head coach of Old Dominion. Record very impressive. 13-9 in the NCAAs. All the way, of course, to the finals last year before losing out to Tennessee. Was an assistant when they won it all in 84-85. And she goes head-to-head with Kay Yao. Legendary gold medal winning Olympic coach. And, of course, longtime coach at NC State. Roberts' numbers very impressive. Something to watch in this matchup against Melvin is that Roberts is a left-hander. Some different pivot moves going on, and Melvin's a righty. One thing both players talked about yesterday. We'll get physical.
B. Shepard had her initially, but they did look to double down. Shepard was the one who picked up the personal.
Gillespie outside the arc. High post feed from Melvin between the wickets. And Eplin comes up with a steal.
That's what Old Dominion does. They create opportunities off their defensive pressure.
Evelyn, school's best three-point shooter. She is dangerous from anywhere in long range. Loves shooting the triples. Team's motion leader, Mary Andrade. Benicero tries a high-low play. It's deflected straight up in the air. Good D by NC State. They are quick. Rochelle Jones comes free. 4-1 Wolfpack very early in this game. Jumper from Lewis off the mark, foul down low. He's going to be against the Wolfpack. That first shot from Gillespie counted as a two.
The Kayao's club initially has done an outstanding job limiting transition opportunities for Old Dominion. You've got to slow Old Dominion down. Don't allow them to get out in transition. As you see, 13th NCAA. Those are numbers at the Wolfpack, 493. She does have 550 career wins.
Team 23-6 doors coming in. That's her 16th 20-win season. Roberts free to easy. Lefty lay-in.
Well, they got her isolated on the block against Shepard. She merely pins high side. She's got a tremendous frame. She holds position beautifully.
Still the zone defense. Watch how Penichero works at the top of the zone. She'll flash in. Try to fake like she's taking a charge when the point guard penetrates and then gets in that passing lane. That's where she gets a lot of her steals. She is very quick. Shepard tied up by Penichero on the strip. ODU has some numbers. Tisha flipped past Roberts on the move a bit too hard. Melvin a hand, the rebound. Andrade falling down, travels. And the Wolfpack gets it back. So early on, good action inside. 4-3 game, Wolfpack. Welcome back. We asked longtime NC State head coach Kay Yao about finally making an appearance in the Final Four, but she's more concerned about her star player, Chastity Melvin, making it.
Every year I'll have another chance next year. Chastity won't have another chance. And for what she's done for our program, helped to bring us back in prominence and helped to take us to four NCAA tournaments since she's been there. And for all that she's meant to our program, I would love nothing better than for her to have that opportunity.
Melvin, the number one ACC rebounder, second in field goal percentage, has had an amazing season and quite a career as well. Down in Raleigh, when she first came, the program was struggling, had some down years, but it's brought them right back to national prominence.
The full court pressure handled nicely by NC State. You've got to be able to take the pressure.
But the shot clock down to five. Lewis in the baseline double team, nowhere to go with it. Summer Erb is into the game for the first time. And shot on the wing by Jones. Was it in time?
She got it off.
She did.
It counts. Good job by Lewis not to panic. She was double teamed along the baseline. Looked like she was in jail, but the freshman responds calmly.
P. Shepard is out for NC State. Summer Erb, a 6'6 transfer from Purdue, sees her first action. Benicero hangs, good feet for Roberts, but stripped away from behind. Back to Tisha, long three not there. Summer Erb really scrapping hard, hits the hardwood with a thump. NC State comes away with it.
You get a feel for how tough it is to handle Roberts down there one-on-one on the block.
Lewis in the corner, Gillespie, another long-range shot rattles out. Chastity Melvin working hard down low, lays it home.
She didn't have position, but she's got tremendously long arms, Chastity Melvin. She keeps the ball alive better than anyone in the country, I think, with those long arms. Got herself an opportunity.
And two outings against Maine and Youngstown State, 20 points and 19 respectively. So she stepped up big time in the first two rounds for the Wolfpack. And Achero and Andrade. Melvin checking Mary Andrade. That's something to watch as well. Whereas Erb is matching up with Roberts down low. Penichero stripped from behind. Gillespie may have reached in. Jones involved as well. Well, a moment ago we saw Rochelle Jones barely beat the shot clock. Let's listen and see how close it was.
Looks like she released it before it buzzed. So indeed it counts. And Tanisha Lewis was the one in the trap. She handled it beautifully.
Naya Wallace will check into the NC State lineup for the first time. She's a sophomore guard from Camden, New Jersey. And Natalie Diaz makes her first appearance for ODU. She has been fighting off some major leg problems. As Latoya Small checks out, Diaz just returned to the lineup during the tournament after a stress fracture of her left leg. Melvin, another strong rebound. Fires the outlet pass, and Wallace on the move.
Thus far, NC State doing a pretty good job on the backboards defensively.
Erb the missed shot, turn around, her first attempt of the game. Benicero, dancing into the front court again. Very elusive offensively. Fires down low, good feet, Andrade. Try to hit Roberts, she's tied up. And it's out of bounds. No possession arrow, a 20-second timeout. Called by Old Dominion and head coach Wendy Larry.
Well, if you're Kay Yao right now, what you should be saying during this 20-second timeout is when trying to defend Nyree Roberts on the block, she's a left-hander. She can't score with her right hand, so you jump to her right shoulder, Dave, and you don't let her shoot lefty.
Well, coming up, more women's college basketball on ESPN2. You talk about sensational Saturday, this is it. Coverage on ESPN and ESPN2 all day and all night for the NCAA Women's Championship. Notre Dame and Purdue in the Midwest. That's from Lubbock, Texas, in the Mideast. From Nashville, Illinois, and North Carolina go head-to-head on ESPN2. Much more college basketball coming your way. It's just the beginning.
Been all man-to-man through the first 6 minutes for NC State.
They are very intense to us on defense. Shot clock is coming down to 10 here. Roberts in the pivot. That's the banker again using that left hand.
But, and you see she's turning to her left every time she wants to shoot the basketball. Get to her right shoulder, force her to go right. Nyree Roberts too good going to her left.
She's 2 of 3 early. Hit for 5 points. Gillespie came off some major injury problems of her own last year and badly bruised an elbow in the NCAAs, but she's all right, not wearing a brace like she had on yesterday. Shot clock at 4. Gillespie tries on the right side, a bit short. Evelyn hustling for the rebound off for Ferrichero. She'll lead Andrade into the corner.
Again, good transition defense. They're finding people, they're identifying.
Pops a three-pointer. Count it, and a foul on Chastity Melvin. Chance for a 4-point play, and there's the emotion we talked about with Mary Andrade, you bet.
He is the heart and soul of Old Dominion, and transition basketball is where this club is at its best. You see, initially, they get out and defend, but you don't leave a shooter. Pennichero gets it back, kicks it to the shooter, and drains it. And yes, she can dig it.
Andrade hit the floor very hard in their second round game. Down at Norfolk, was shaken up. And Wendy Larry was concerned she might have a slight concussion, but thankfully for ODU, she's all right.
Looks like a little 2-on-2 pressure, but again handled.
NC State very disciplined with the ball. So far, not a lot of mistakes despite that frenetic defense from ODU.
Well, they throw so many wrinkles. Sometimes they trap, sometimes they don't. But look at the freshman step up and drain it.
Michelle Lewis, long range. You can see her walk afterwards. A little strut in her step. She's confident. Now, Lewis said she, the last couple of years, has watched the Andrades and Roberts and Tisha Panichero on television making Final Fours. Now she gets to play against them. She was so excited telling us about it yesterday.
Well, we asked her, would there be any intimidation? She said no. She said, I played in the ACC, a tremendous conference.
So thanks to a shot like that from the freshman, Tanisha Lewis. No fear in NC State's game. They lead by 2 against the top seed. 45.5% from the field led NC State to an early lead on the top seed. Old Dominion today from Dayton. Welcome back, Dave Ryan, Doris Burke. We talked about ACC really coming along. Here are the teams at the end of the season in the top 25 poll.
Well, it just goes to show you that conference seasons prepares you for the NCAA tournament. NC State is very relaxed. They're confident. They're handling the pressure, and I think that's probably partly due to their conference schedule and how it prepares them for this type of situation.
Virginia was in the East Regional as well, lost in the second round last weekend. Tucson, Arizona, we'll see them on ESPN. Coming up next against UConn, and Andrade charging down low.
Great defense again by the freshman. She just steps in, knows Andrade's right-handed, knows she wants to go to her right. Spectacular defensive play. See, you think there's a mismatch because of size, but look at her step in and take it. Chastity Melvin told us yesterday, as you see Evelyn go out and Latoya Small come in. She told us yesterday, you asked her, you said, Chastity, are you concerned about Tanisha and her response tomorrow in the Sweet 16? And her response is absolutely not.
No lack of confidence with Tanisha Lewis's game. No question, we've seen that already. Hitting a big three-pointer and then that defensive stop on Andrade a moment ago. Steal Panichero again. Such quick hands. Small and Panichero. Tisha left open. Saw that a moment ago, and Andrade badly burned NC State with a four-point play. Roberts the kick out. And he resets.
And a switch with Shepherd out of the game. Melvin now checks Roberts.
Diaz may have gotten away with a walk. Final second before the shot clock violation rattles out.
North Carolina
lost the rebound.
They've got an 8-6 advantage on the boards to start this thing.
Long three-pointer, Walls a bit short. Rebound loose, Panichero grabs it. ODU will run and gun. Hanging shot from Tisha Panichero, and she's fouled on the way up. She'll have a couple of free throws with the pack still up by a bucket.
The key to guarding Tisha Panichero is to get in front of her early. Don't allow her to build up ahead of steam. You should really stop basketball when you're checking her before she gets to the half court line. When you allow her to get this deep, she's got the ability to go to the hole hard, hang in the air, draw body contact. She's so dangerous because she can finish with the basketball in her hands and she sees other people. Look at those assist numbers. Fifth in the country.
And number one in the nation steals per game as well. It's not on there. Another accolade that she's been able to rack up on her resume. And just think, as we see Herb come back in the game, Melvin takes a seat. The foul is on Lewis, by the way, her first. And Atera did not have to come back from senior year. She already has a degree, could have turned pro. We know both leagues would love to have her, any team would, but opted for that quest for the dream. Another shot at an NCAA title after coming so close a year ago.
We asked her how much of that played into your decision, and she said, well, I won't be disappointed. I won't feel like it was a waste of a year. But you definitely got the sense that that's a big part of the reason she came back.
Small created that steal off the bottom of the backboard, and ODU keeps the ball. 21 seconds on the shot clock. Boy, that Toya Small went way up across the court right in front of the Monarch bench a moment ago for Wendy Larry's team. Turnover numbers so far as Evelyn is back in for the Monarchs. Diaz out, pretty even to this point.
But that's Old Dominion's game. They like to turn it over, and the key for them is can they score off the turnovers?
Panichero holds on that pivot foot, but barely. A bounce pass for Roberts. And look at the hustle from NC State. They're really filling the passing lanes. Gillespie has defect. 2-on-2 chance. Got Lewis with her. She'll pull it out. Aisha Lewis. Here's Michelle Jones. Bothered all year by a back problem. Talk more about that throughout this game, but Herb at 6'6", spins in the low, right block and hits.
Yeah, she's a transfer from Purdue, had to sit out a year, has showed flashes of brilliance. Herb, great size, great touch. They just need her to be a consistent performer.
And coming down the court, we saw Summer Herb and Roberts really exchanging some strong elbows in there. It's getting physical. Great drive, Panichero foul on the way up. Michelle Jones not pleased with the call. She maybe whistled for the personal. A couple free throws now for Tisha.
Yeah, Tisha Panichero has played on the Portuguese national team since she was 14 years old. She is a seasoned basketball player. You talk about Europeans, you typically think of more maturity, and Panichero just spectacular dribble penetration. And Michelle Jones has got her hands full, as you can see, already her third.
So Jones in big foul trouble. Team has six here in the first half. And very quickly, Kate Yao is going to get her out of the lineup. Bates will come in for the first time. Another freshman has played a key role as Small checks out for ODU as well. Monica Bates from Manchester, Tennessee. There's some pressure off the made free throw. Bates tested early. Lewis fires for a wide opener, can't finish. Bates, good hustle. She's bumped hard by Panichero from behind, and Tisha picks up the personal. She knew it, raising that hand up into the air. Tisha telling us yesterday about how important it is for her to stay out of foul trouble. She's so tempted when she sees the ball because of the quick hands to try to make a steal all the time.
Yeah, Wendy Larry said she's got to keep people on the floor. It's the first time, this is the first game where they've had the full complement of guards back on the floor in their lineup. And Small will check back in. And that series, though, a moment ago by NC State was the first time they attacked the pressure where they got an easy look. They've been content to break and set.
What a job by Panichero away from the ball. Nayla Wallace charged into her. Tisha had the position. And another foul on NC State. That is the team's seventh left from free throws in the other end. Watch this.
Well, this play is going to get Old Dominion shooting the bonus early. Away from the play, she goes to set a screen. And Panichero hits the deck.
Tisha, very crafty, quick player. We talked about that, but so smart on the floor as well. Positioning on defense is so important when you make that many steals, not just a lucky number. But her teammates tell us also it's an instinct. Nyah Roberts was talking about that yesterday. A lot of things you can't teach about how quick she is and anticipates.
Well, early on in her career, when she first came to Old Dominion, she was so quick with her passes. Some people took some things in the face. As you see the foul situation we alluded to a moment ago, already in the bonus.
All free throw points so far for Panichero. Nearly had a steal against Herb on the inbounds play. Alicia Lewis triple teamed, handles it well.
I was gonna say, don't pick up your dribble there, but I think she had an idea. She wanted to go to the weak side of the floor.
Wallace tried to hit Bates, who was flashing through the paint, batted out of bounds. NC State keeps it. 16 on the shot clock.
She's trying to make the call from the sideline. Saying it was dipped.
Gillespie needs some help quickly. Tries a bouncer for Bates. And it's tied up. Panichero got it briefly. And she tried to get the ball away to Diaz, but out of bounds.
Old Dominion so phenomenally quick defensively. The pressure, the intensity on that end of the floor.
Lady Monarchs have grabbed the lead 14-13 and been trailing most of the first half. Bates, the freshman, way too hard. But Irma follow, foul from behind. Small may have gotten just a little bit. Oh, look at Wendy Laird. She can't believe the call is going against her Monarchs.
Well, great hops by Small, and I think she had a lot of ball. Wendy Larry might be correct. We're going to get the benefit of a second look. Herb on the weak side glass. Oh, ball. Indeed.
Nobody there.
No.
Nothing doing. One more free throw. Well, Larry jumped up a few feet in the air after that call went against Blair Latoya Small.
Only the third team foul against Old Dominion. First on Small.
Second one rattles out. She redshirted last year after the transfer from Purdue. A couple years ago, played 28 games in summer with the Boilermakers. But a key factor here, because of the size, Nyree Roberts down low is almost 6'4 herself. Andrade. Misha Panichero may have gotten away with a little elbow flailing there. Lewis somehow grabs the rebound while sitting down on the court. Another foul coming up against ODU.
And that's the one you don't need if you're Panichero. You said it a moment ago. She knows she's got to be on the floor. But check Tanisha Lewis out. She tries to draw the charge. It looks like it might have been. She's laying down. She's got the presence to know the rebound's coming. Kicks it to a teammate.
Almost out of bounds there, but she was barely in.
She's working with a seat.
So Panichero does get her second personal. Team's fourth. That is very important for ODU. Keep an eye on that. Now how aggressive she'll be.
She's going to have to be smart and tone down her aggressiveness so they might attack her in the zone.
Kristen Gillespie off for Bates. Long three, Lewis. Rattles out. Bates a hand of the rebound, working hard down low, but lost it out of bounds. And the Lady Monarchs get it back tied up at 14.
You've got to continue to do that if you're Bates and Herb. Work the glass hard as the bomber, Aubrey Eblin, comes back in.
Small, quickly checking out. So Wendy Larry using a lot of substitutes. Melvin still on the bench for NC State. And give the Wolfpack some credit. They're hanging right in there with the top seed without Chastity Melvin, their leading scorer and rebounder. Down low, Andrade got three. Somehow got that shot up and nearly spun it in. Shot some free throws.
Well, Murray Andrade moves extremely well without the basketball, and that's the key. When you're away from the rock, you've got to keep moving your feet, working and working and working for position. She's got Bates on her. She's using her body. She's very, very strong and able to take the hit and almost get it to go.
Andrade twisted an ankle in the first half of that game with Nebraska in the second round down at the ODU Fieldhouse last weekend, and as we said, slammed her head on the floor in a layup that she had her feet from Panichero on a break.
Very concerned about her health and well-being, but good to go today. And hit the free throw tries. ODU still in a zone defense. We've seen a little bit of man, but mostly the zone. Long outside shot nailed there on Ayla Wallace. She wanted a three, and she'll get it.
She had 14 points, Wallace, in the first two rounds.
Effective offensive support off the Wolfpack bench for KU's team. Up by three. Girardi almost carried it, somehow got the pass off. Good adjustment to Diaz. Shot clock at seven. Whistle away for the ball. 3 second call against Old Dominion. So a turnover. Andrade apparently had a foot in the paint. 3 point game. The emotions running high. Wolfpack, Lady Monarchs from Dayton. More coming up in the Sweet 16. Now, fans have made a pretty long trip from Norfolk, Virginia, all the way to Dayton, Ohio for the Sweet 16 game. But so far, they've seen too much of this. NC State's leading three-point shooter, Nyla Wallace, nailing a long one.
Well, they've had good patience against the zone. Wallace, not a tremendous defender, but as I said, at 14 in the first two rounds, gives them a lot on the offensive end.
Game summary to this point. ODU really struggling, and from the field, they haven't scored a field goal in more than 5 minutes. Melvin on the bench with two fouls, but still NC State has got the lead.
And look at the number of free throws they've shot thus far, 11 already.
ODU, a freshman on the floor, and Jessica Williams from Wilmington, North Carolina, getting her first action. Bates in the corner. Baseline jumper nails it.
Ball reversal against the zone will get you uncontested looks. Move the basketball quicker than the defense could move.
Came in averaging 3.5 a game. A big shot there. Foul away from the ball against ODU. And if it's Tisha Panichero, that's her third. We'll see who's the guilty party. She was in the vicinity.
Nope. I don't believe it. I think it went on Jessica Williams.
Sure did. That's her first. So sigh of relief for Old Dominion. That could have been disastrous.
And NC State yet to get into the bonus. Old Dominion with just 5 team fouls.
Lewis, low post feed. Herb was double teamed. Bates with some confidence. Shot clock cut in half to 15. Nisha Lewis. Andrade right in her face. Nowhere to go. Shot clock at 5. She's tied up. Great play by Mary Andrade. That is pressure defense textbook style. And they'll get the ball back on the possession arrow.
Well, Old Dominion known for their defensive pressure and the things they create. Everybody cheats up. They extend this 2-3 so far out. You've got to read the floor. Nobody sees Tanisha Lewis in trouble. The key against the zone, Dave, is when you see it moving, you've got to get to open spaces. Make cuts to the open area of the floor.
Amber Eller-Paul, number 4, gets her first action for ODU. She's had a knee problem. They were concerned about her health. See the right knee of hers wrapped up pretty carefully. Strained it toward the end of the season. A foul down low against the Wolfpack, and we'll have some free throws.
North Carolina State foul number 5, Ayla Wallace.
There.
That's her second.
The bandaging, which you were just speaking to. Eller-Paul was outstanding in this round for Old Dominion and Wendy Lowry a year ago. Had a tremendous game. She and Diaz against Florida last year to go to the Final Four were spectacular.
The buzzer before the shot. The shot clock and the clock for our scoreboard is down to zeros. So are the score. I guess we're starting over again. I don't think so.
I don't think Kay Yao would agree with that.
Well, the way her team is playing, without Chastity Melvin, she's been on the bench for the last 5-plus minutes with the two fouls.
That horn sounded just as the free throw was released. It did go in. It should count.
So the official timers will get things reset. Yeah, good question on the free throw as to how that's going to work. We still have goose eggs all around. No score, no time on the game clock here in Dayton. What happened just a moment ago, where everything went down, we were talking about Amber Eller-Paul and her knee problems. And you can see our clock went as well. It's connected to the official game clock. Putting up 6:04. Remaining in the first half. And the Pack up by 5.
And Old Dominion has struggled getting some field goals. They're really staying in this one from the free throw line. Over the last 6 minutes, 40 seconds, Old Dominion 0 of 2 field goals, but 6 of 9 from the foul line.
So no field goals for the Lady Monarchs since Andrade had the 4-point play when Melvin picked up her foul. The first free throw did count, so it's officially a 19-15 game. Further stat about the struggles from the field. Last 7 points. 40 have all come from the free throw line. Roberts tries to make it 8 to pull her team within 3 here in the first half. From Dayton, Sweet 16 game. Talked about the past success NC State has had against Old Dominion, and that's carried through here, Doris. No intimidation factor at all. Play.
Oh, they are responding and handling the pressure. And that was something we knew they had quits to match up defensively, but what we were concerned about was how these young kids would play in this round of 16. And we said there was a long series history between these two, and NC State actually with the advantage, 16-12.
That game was at Norfolk a year ago, and boy, Tisha Panichero got emotional about it. When we asked her regarding that game last year, she says, "I still think about it to this day." The 2 losses they had last year. Shot clock now at 8. Lewis lost the handle. Diaz, great hustle. And it will stay NC State's ball, but just 5 seconds on the shot clock remain.
And Lewis had really nowhere to go, so this might not hurt you. You can set up a screen off the inbound and hopefully get a quick hit.
Gillespie will inbound. Looks for help. They don't want to give it to Herb so far from the basket. Bates penetrates, hanging shot not there. Panichero handed the rebound and Roberts pulls it down. Hello, Paul in the offensive end. She often is a backup point guard. And they're very concerned about team depth with her knee problem, but she's out there today.
Ivory Roberts getting a little bit frustrated. She wants the basketball. They're not getting it to her.
Good speed. Nyella Wallace hanging shot hits. Remember, we talked about Diaz with her leg problems, just coming back from a stress fracture. Doesn't have the speed when the ball was loose. Wallace quickly went right around her and got the easy deuce. NC State by 6. Andrade posted up on Bates. A bit too hard. Rebound loose. And Gillespie's got another board. A pretty big team, even in the backcourt, NC State is. So they got some rebounding help from back there.
Yeah, they're up 14-10. Advantage on the glass to NC State thus far.
Bird is posted up. Summers played very well against Robertson. Andrade down low, trying to hit there. In the absence of Melvin, what a rebound. Again, the freshman can't hit, though. Lewis not there, but Summer Herb a follow and a couple of fists as well. Look at the Wolfpack up by 8.
And they just turn it over. Old Dominion, an unforced error and everything going the Wolfpack way right now. Rebounding has been key early on. Tanisha Lewis takes one away from Panichero, goes up, won't get it to go, but Summer Herb, who's been big in this game by virtue of her 6'5 frame and her play, gets the fist going at the end of that one.
And then the inbound play, Andrade stepped over the line. That's a violation, giving the ball right back to the Wolfpack. So Wendy Larry has got quite a few things to talk about on the Lady Monarch sideline.
Well, when we talked to her yesterday, she said the thing she likes about this team and the thing this team brings to the table that last year's team didn't is experience in championship play. That last error, not championship caliber basketball, and she's letting her club know it. Tanisha Lewis has been outstanding. All rookie performer in the ACC, was the leading rookie of the week vote getter. They thought she had a real good shot at rookie of the year, but Nikki Teasley of North Carolina came away with that one.
Timeout called by NC State. Yeah, there was a little bit of hard feelings as well with NC State regarding Melvin not getting the ACC Player of the Year. Tracy Reed from North Carolina won as well, so their arch rival took 2 awards, and the Wolfpack didn't get any. Well, we talked with Chastity Melvin about that yesterday. She wasn't so upset about it, but her parents were devastated that she didn't win the award because they had read in a Raleigh newspaper her name was on top of the All-ACC team. They thought it meant she had won the award. So it was kind of a tough couple days for her. Everyone went up to her and said, hey, congratulations on the player of the year, but she had not won it. She felt very badly for Lewis not winning the ACC Rookie of the Year.
Well, she was more concerned with that. She felt like Lewis had contributed greatly to this club, considering they lost Katie Smirk, a W transfer to Georgetown, and Jen Howard from the backcourt.
Well, she's gone more than 8 minutes without an ODU field goal. 12:42 of the first half, the last mark they had one. In low again, Earp trying a bit too hard. Had a hand on the rebound. Naila Wallace is foul on the way up.
Well, I'll tell you what, Summer Herb comes into this ball game averaging just under 14 minutes, and Wendy Larry's club has had all they can handle with this young sophomore center for Kay Yao, and Kay said she's got all the skills. She's got to become a consistent worker and performer.
Boy, she stepped up big, but Panettiere on the fast hands against the freshman Lewis. She took it right away, penetrates and hits. Cisa Panettiere, a big basket there for ODU. They had gone 8-plus minutes without a field goal. Tisha's up to 7 points and the lead back to 6.
You know, Tisha Panettiere in the open floor has reminded many Old Dominion fans of Nancy Lieberman Klein, and to be mentioned in the same breath with Nancy is quite a tribute.
Shot clock at 10. Nayila Wallace in some trouble. Here's Kristen Gillespie away from the ball, a push. It's going to go against Bates of NC State. Look at Tisha Panettiere away from the basketball, drawing fouls, the second time that's happened.
Well, Andrade and Panettiere are very good actresses on the floor, and I don't think she, yeah, she hit her, but does she have to take that kind of a flop? I don't know, but, you know, that's all part of the game. They understand it. She'll get herself to the free throw line. That's 10 team fouls. So we're shooting two through the last 3.5 minutes here.
We talked about her relation in terms of climbing the record books at ODU. She's got 936 career assists coming into this game. She needed 26 to pass Lady Magic. Nancy Lieberman Klein at the top of the list with 961. She is number one all time in steals. Leads the nation in that category. Couple of free throws and a pump of the fist from Tisha Panettiere. She's getting emotionally charged, and ODU is making a comeback thanks to great plays like that from the senior. Well, welcome back to Dayton. NC State leads by 4. We saw the emotion of Tisha Panettiere and Mary Andrade on the court. We saw the same sort of emotional reaction when we asked head coach of Old Dominion, Wendy Larry, about last year's run of the national title, coming so close but losing.
It truly is 6 months of agony because you just don't cross the finish line. But a season that will always be just a tremendous memory, not because so much of the defeat, but because of the special people that were a part of it.
Their only loss last year to graduation, Clarice Mashinguana, another Kodak All-American along with Panettiere, who's now playing in the ABL.
Shot clock under 10. Lewis, the freshman, penetrates. Good pass off, and Herb hits another big shot on the baseline. Summer Herb has really come to play today.
Well, she realized on penetration, she just steps to the basket. When somebody penetrates, everybody else has got to make themselves available.
7 points. 3 rebounds for Summer Herb already in this game. Small at the free throw line. Driving that wide open, a long three, can't hit. NC State definitely letting them take perimeter shots. That's part of the strategy, you can tell.
Yeah, I think you've got to identify certain players. Certainly the bomber Aubrey Evelyn, you've got to be aware of. Ella Paul can shoot it.
Down low and free for an easy lay-in. Andrade.
But if they're going to beat you, that's where they'll do it, with Roberts and Andrade and Panettiere on penetration.
You can tell Andrade really trying to pick up the team emotionally now. A sluggish first half for ODU. Panettiere has 2 fouls. That may be aiding in the lack of aggressiveness. Lewis, a drive, hanging shot, a bit too hard. Look at Herb fighting again over Roberts and brings her down to the hardwood with her. Possession arrow is going to NC State. Coming up on the Deuce, the Lee Jeans halftime report. We'll hear from Robin Roberts, Mimi Griffin, and Rebecca Lobo in our studio Highlights going on of Louisiana Tech, the three seed against Alabama. We know all about Bama's run here to the Sweet 16, plus first half analysis from our game as well. The Lee Jeans halftime report is coming up.
La Tech is stacked, and they've got one of the all-time great coaches on the sidelines in Leon Barmore. And Mimi alluded to it when she has stated that La Tech brings five athletes to the floor that are actually better in terms of just pure athleticism than Tennessee, and they're a team that certainly can beat the Volunteers.
Number 24, Amora Keenan, you saw her checking in, a 6'5 junior transfer. She's from Wellington, New Zealand, so another import who's on the floor in this game. And 2 minutes left, first half. NC State has been impressive. Bat out of bounds by ODU. Pete Shepard will come back in for NC State. Looking at the bracket, East Region. These two games to determine who plays on Monday, 5 o'clock Eastern, for a shot at the Final Four. We'll have the next game for you on ESPN, Arizona-UConn, and the regional final Monday, 5 o'clock on ESPN. Again, Irv gets free, and again she hits. Give her 9 first half points.
She's had some big games, had 25 points, 10 boards against Maryland earlier this year.
Yeah, she showed up with some big ones, no question. Shepard, a good strong rebound and a miss by Roberts. Again, going to that left hand. Kayal has put in some very good strategy to try to neutralize Nyree Roberts in this game.
Well, that's why Summer Irv is getting so many minutes, because physically she matches up so well with Nyree Roberts.
Markin, good rebound. Panichero pushes up court. Drive, hanging shot, hits it. Some magical moves from Tisha Panichero. There's another prime example. The lead is 4.
Yeah, she made that look easy, but that is a phenomenally tough shot. Body on you, going away from the hoop.
With the right hand,
yeah,
indeed.
With
that's
the right hand, that's going against your body.
She's got 11 points. That's a game high. No one else has broken into double figures yet. Lewis, shot clock at 8. Hanging jumper from 10, not there. Gets the rebound. Tanisha Lewis working hard down low, can't get it to fall.
Great board work again. 19 boards, 20 now for NC State.
Another half a minute, first half.
The key against Old Dominion's pressure is you've got to be patient.
Shot clock at 15, game clock at 16, a 1 second difference. Nayella Wallace, left side shot, perfect.
Well, you got to take good looks if you get them. You know you're going to give them another opportunity, but a wide open 8-foot jump shot, you got to take it.
Final seconds, Panichero hanging shot, not there. Roberts a layup, yes, it counts. At the buzzer, Nyree Roberts hits a big shot, but the first half story, Summer Irv, 9 points, more than a point and a half over her season average. So at the break, it's a 4-point Wolfpack lead. Let's go back to the studio now on Robin Roberts.
All right, Dave, thank you very much. NC State has not been to the round of 16 since 95, and in the early going, they looked a little jittery, not as confident as in the first two rounds, but they have really settled down now.
They have settled down, and State did a great job of coming out and hitting their outside shots, which were there because Old Dominion was in a 2-3 zone. As a result, Old Dominion came out, they went man-to-man, State decided to go inside to Summer Irv, take it to the basket. They also need to try to draw some more fouls to get to the free throw line, get Old Dominion's foul trouble.
And Rebecca, during the game, Doris mentioned that the thing that State was doing so well is they were taking away transition buckets of Old Dominion, and it was a great point by Doris. The other thing that they do so well is in the half court, they're playing Nyree Roberts off her right shoulder. She loves to turn off that right shoulder and take a little lefty shot. They're not giving her the shots that she likes. She's taking shots, just not the one she wants.
And the all-name team, Summer Irv. We love that.
It's got to be a stage name.
It has to be. But that is it at the half. They're up by 4 points. Well, we have much more to come here on the Lee Jeans Halftime Report. We'll check in on Louisiana Tech. Their sixth straight Sweet 16 appearance. They're taking on Alabama. We'll have action of that matchup when we come back.
ESPN's presentation of the NCAA Women's Basketball Tournament is brought to you by Chrysler, engineered to be great cars.
Back here on the Lee Jeans Halftime Report, want to check in Lubbock between Louisiana Tech and Alabama as they close in toward the first half. Tech still with a lead, 26-17 over Alabama. We're at the half between ODU and NC State. The Lady Monarchs are down by 4B. What do they need to do here in the second half?
Well, basically, they did a good job in the first half of getting themselves to the free throw line. The second half, they need to get their running and transition game going. NC State, on the other hand, has done a great job, able to hit the outside shots against the zone, take it to the basket against the man-to-man. They need to just keep doing what they're doing.
I don't think I like this order. You first, me second. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, yeah. Old Dominion, two things. Defense, they've got to make their transition come off their defensive effort, and rebounding, they've got to do a better job on the boards in the second half.
Ooh, and it's early, folks. It's early, and they're already getting after it. All right, and we're at the half. ODU is trailing NC State by 4, 29-25. The second half is straight ahead, so stay with us, everyone. In other words, come on back.
To this point, we've seen two number one seeds go down. Texas Tech and Stanford. Perhaps here in the East, another one is due for an upset. We'll see. Another half to go. Welcome back to Dayton. Dave Ryan, Doris Burke. First half, Summer Herb was outstanding, filling in for Chastity Melvin, who played all 9 minutes for the Pack.
If you would have told me that Chastity Melvin would have 2 points and NC State would have been up 4 at the half, I would have told you you were crazy. But Summer Herb off the bench has been outstanding. They got 31 shots to Old Dominion's 19. Summer Herb playing because she matches up well with Nyree Roberts. She rebounded. She scored. She was a presence on the defensive side against Roberts. And she was the key in getting the advantage through the break.
Doris, Summer Herb had 4 20-point games this year, a high of 25, as you mentioned, in the first half. Here are the numbers through 20 minutes.
Well, the free throw shooting that we've highlighted, 15 trips for Old Dominion. They got 10 of their 25 from there. But look at the rebounding numbers. NC State surprisingly up. And we talked about her, Summer Herb, feeling good. 9 points and 4 of 7 shooting.
Herb off the bench, outstanding. How about the bench scoring numbers? This is another one that'll shock you. Look at that. NC State 18 zip in that category.
Herb has half of those, and I think, you know, something I mentioned, only 19 shots by Old Dominion, 31 shots taken by North Carolina State. Old Dominion known for their transition game, defensive pressure turning into offense, but NC State transition defense has been key, and they have handled that, rebounding another key for them. They have done that, and Chastity Melvin only played 9 minutes, will look to become more of a factor. Herb will start on the bench. But something tells me we might see her pretty quickly.
Yeah, I'll say. Big contributions in the first half for her. Toya Small. Will inbounds right in front of us. Jessica Penichero having some last words to the officials about what she can and can't get away with, I'm sure. Down by 4, starting the second half.
State stays with the man-to-man.
Edwin lights up from three-point range.
Evelyn not heard from in the first half. Her first 3 points of the ball game.
And some pressure off that made three. Nate starts the second half. She played well in the opening 20 minutes also. As did Naima Wallace. So a couple of reserves begin play in the second half. Kay Yao of the NC State Wolfpack. 23-6 record. Old Dominion ranked number 2 in the nation. 29-2 mark. Coming in. Long shot Gillespie way off the mark. Did hit the rim, recovered by Tanisha Lewis, and she hits on the baseline.
Old Dominion stays with the 2-3 zone. And rebounding continues to be a key, the 22nd board of the game for NC State.
Freshman Lewis, 7 points. Roddy and Bates involved in very physical play in the paint. See that to the left of your screen. Shot clock at 10. High post feed Andrade. Good pump fake with a left hand. Tough move. Small hand on the rebound. And they'll reset.
Well, they'll get another opportunity, but tempo is critical when you play Old Dominion. And NC State, for most of this, has handled it and controlled it.
Foul inside. Andrade help picking it up. And again, getting her teammates emotionally charged. You can see her left hand has 2 fingers taped up. She jammed a finger in addition to spraining a wrist and hurting her neck in that last game they played in the NCAAs against Youngstown State.
Monica Bates just picked up number 3.
Check that against Nebraska in the second round. So she's got the finger tied up. That may affect things, but right now, Aubrey Edlin is feeling it from long range. Second straight triple.
She had 3 threes in the first 5 minutes in the second round game against Nebraska. She can take over with her long-distance abilities.
Suddenly, we're tied. Lewis down low from Melvin with a right hand. Spin shot. And a low right block rattles out.
Great look. Tough to defend. Baby hook jump shot.
Benachero, a pump fake and a leaner. Not there. Ayla Wallace, strong rebound. She'll run the other way. Lewis outside the three-point arc. Long shot, Wallace. Front rim not there. And Roberts, a strong rebound for ODU. They can take the lead.
Great checkout for Roberts.
Andrade, good feed. And Nyree Roberts will finish.
All momentum going Old Dominion's way. Roberts, when she came in as a freshman, thank you. She weighed 245 pounds. She has lost 50. She's hovering around 200. She's in great shape compared to when she came out of St. Anthony's High School in Jersey City.
Down low from Melvin again. Little baby hook this time is perfect.
She really can't defend that. That baby hook, you keep the basketball away from the defender. The only way to get a block shot is to lean across and pick up a foul. And Old Dominion electing not to do that.
Melvin desperately does not want this to be her final game. Senior. We're up about an hour from Raleigh, and always wanted to play major Division I college basketball. Andrade, shot clock at 7 against Evelyn, and again she hits! Make it 3 balls in a row for Aubrey Evelyn. She hot.
Identify shooters, and you got to stay in Evelyn's shorts.
Melvin, Nyla Wallace on the baseline. Tough move, and she hits. Aubrey Evelyn from Chillicothe, Ohio, about 90 minutes from here. She told us yesterday a lot of friends and family are going to be on hand to watch her play in person. They don't often get all the way to Virginia for games. A push called on Bates at the top of the key. Andrade goes down hard.
That should be Bates number 4, but again, the flop by Andrade.
It is 4. Herb is going to come back in. Michelle Jones is in. Wallace out. Again, a look at Aubrey Evelyn. Just on fire from long range.
Well, you're in man-to-man if you're NC State, and whoever checks Aubrey Evelyn does not give any defensive help. Monica Bates picks up 4. Andrade forces that one.
4 fouls on the freshman from Manchester, Tennessee. Down low, Roberts, again to left. Oh, good high-low feed, and Latoya Small finishes.
Excellent bounce pass by Roberts. She felt the double team and a good read by her teammate to step to the basket and make herself available.
Break the pressure. Lewis, right side shot. Bit too strong. Roberts, a very, very good rebound again for ODU.
In the first half, NC State had 11 offensive rebounds. Old Dominion much better checking them off the glass.
Small looks for 2 in a row. Batted around by Lewis, got a hand on it. And a foul call against ODU. Roberts, by the way, up to 8 rebounds now.
Small came over the back.
Timeout on the floor. ODU has stormed back. Great second half play against KU's Wolfpack. It's a 3-point game. Two teams in our next game, Arizona. You see Adia Barnes, bottom left of your screen. UConn on top with Rita Williams and all the stars of that team, Amy Duran. They go head-to-head in the next round. We'll have that game for you on ESPN at approximately 2 o'clock Eastern time. Here, Evelyn has really caught fire. We welcome all of you watching from down in Lubbock, Louisiana Tech and Alabama. That's Sweet 16 game. This is University of Dayton Arena, Dayton, Ohio. Dave Ryan, Doris Burke with you. NC State, Old Dominion, Sweet 16 game, East Regional, semifinal. NC State, an outstanding first half, had the lead. Here's Chastity Melvin, low block, not there. And Roberts pulls down her ninth rebound of the game. All-American Tisha Penichero. No-look feed Roberts, who's hit hard from behind by Summer Herb. And for those just joining, Summer Herb, a great first half for us.
She was outstanding for KU. Had 9 points, 4 boards, picks up her first personal foul. But the key in the second half has been two things. The control by Old Dominion of the defensive backboard and their ability to shoot the 3-point shot.
Evelyn drives this time, tries a 2-pointer. And Herb, a strong rebound. She's fouled on the way up. Wendy Larry of Old Dominion, a team that came so close, lost just two games all year. One of those in the national title game in Cincinnati, Riverfront Coliseum, to Tennessee. The Vols went on to that national championship. K.O. on the other side of things for NC State, their head coach, longtime legendary coach from Tobacco Road. Eight times has taken her team to a Sweet 16 game, but has never won and gotten into the Elite Eight. She tries here today against the top seed. Herb on the baseline, hits another.
She's feeling it right now. It took 18 seconds to break the pressure. So I thought maybe they might struggle to get a shot off, but they get it to the baseline, and Herb's got great touch right down there.
Lead is one for ODU. Panichero, good penetration, way too hard. Lewis is upended by Latoya Small. It is physical down low, quite a battle going on. Eight in the shot clock, that shot never hit the rim from Panichero. Andrade goes down, watch out. She's got three fouls, but it's gonna be against Melvin. She has now got three fouls.
North Carolina State foul number 44,
Chesty Melvin. 14-17, second half. ODU by one. Chastity Melvin has three personals. That's very damaging. Again, that off the ball play with position. We've seen that a lot. Melvin a steal. Another example of how hard Panichero fires those passes. She is so quick. Sometimes teammates just aren't ready for it.
Keep your hands up if you're on the court with Tisha Panichero.
Lewis with low block feed, and Chastity Melvin hits again. Turnaround shot.
He thought she'd become a factor here in the second half, and Melvin 6 points on 3 of 5 shooting to go along with 3 boards. That baby hook on the right side of the floor, so tough.
Team leader in points and rebounds. Adler, another try. 3-point range. Are you kidding? She needs no time to release. Brains it.
The bench enjoys it, but Gillespie, after she shot the shot, looked over to bench and said, hey, coach, try to hand up. I'm in her face.
Third three in the second half. She personally has given ODU another lead. Melvin double team as Small drops down on coverage. Shot clock at 17. Eblen feeling it.
You love shooters who don't need time or space. The quick release, Gillespie not in time, number 4 of the half, and has given her team a lead.
4 for 4 threes in the half. She'll check out. Diaz will come in for defensive purposes here. Amelia fans, some of those were sure from Chillicothe, Ohio, are cheering Aubrey Eblen today. Jones lost the handle, right on the sideline, stays in bounds. Michelle Jones in traffic way too hard, and Diaz plucks out the rebound. Andrade, high post. Diaz, as we see Small go down away from the ball again. ODU is making a clinic out of that. Roberts in trouble, fires out Andrade. Long shot, hits it. 2-point jumper, just inside the 3-point arc. And look at the emotion, Mary Andrade.
And she's not a consistent shooter from out there, but the double down on the block on Roberts opened up that jump shot for Mary Andrade.
Crucial stage here, Doris. NC State in the first half was so disciplined with the ball. Didn't lose their composure. Trying there, Melvin can't handle that. Entry pass was partially tipped. Panichero leading Roberts left-handed layup too hard. Herb's got the rebound.
You've got to score if you're NC State, because all the momentum right now with Old Dominion. They need to contain their patience, be patient, do the same things that were effective in the first half, and they need to get on the offensive glass.
Lewis has been very well handled in the second half. Did have one quick bucket. Melvin, a low post feed. Herb, good pass. Jones cutting into the basket. Can't get it to drop. Michelle Jones off the mark today. She's had a rough one. 2 points. And 1 for 4 shooting has not been a factor. Andrade, a kick out. Diaz will drive and hang and shoot and score as well.
Everybody becoming active. Eblen stepped up early. Diaz on the penetration. And a good timeout by K.O.
Emotions running high on both sides. Sudden frustration for NC State, for Old Dominion. Things looking good. A full timeout on the floor and a 6-point lead. Andrade helping with the emotion and helping with the shooting as well. Long range shot, Marianne Roddy. Does she love it? You better believe it. Old Dominion making a big comeback in the second half. They lead by six. Lead is six for Old Dominion. Aubrey Eblen, great outside shooting, but the emotional leadership provided by Mary Andrade, her head coach says, great emotion, great will and desire, too.
We often refer to Mary as our queen of heart, and, you know, she has to share a lot of her emotions with our Old Dominion basketball team because we have some players that are very non-emotional, and so Mary is often the one that's called upon to spread the wealth of emotion that she has.
I think one of the enduring memories from last year's tournament when she missed the shot in their second round game, tears in her eyes. It goes into overtime. She took over 8 points. She knows when to step up.
They did a personal mission last year to help them to the title game. Shot clock at seven. Nailed on the baseline, too strong. Rebound loose. Nayla Wallace has got it. Nisha Lewis in the paint, hanging shot. Good hustle to get the rebound. Oh, and she shoves in Roddy afterwards with an elbow, and a foul is called against Old Dominion.
Wow, I thought that was
on Andrade.
Yeah, I thought that was going against Lewis. It looked like she came over the top, and I think Wendy Larry agrees, or obviously agrees. Key people need to stay on the floor. Andrade with four. If you're Wendy Larry, you got to substitute because there's too much time on the clock.
Maura Keenan from New Zealand will check in. Andrade will come out. She is very upset that she can't participate for the next few minutes with the four fouls. From Lisbon, Portugal. Melvin, a penetration. Try to find Herb on a high low play. Keenan comes free with it. But step to the baseline. Shot clock at 25. NC State gets it back.
A great closeout. It looked like there was going to be an easy bucket by Herb, but the quickness for Old Dominion, they close things down in a hurry.
Melvin did not have a big first half. Shut down just a couple of points. 9 minutes, and she's headed off the court. May have lost a contact lens. That's what I'm guessing. She's at the top of your screen now, seeing the trainer. She's pointing at her left eye a moment ago.
And everybody's looking down on the court to try and spot it. Talk about finding a needle in a haystack. Mm.
The lead six after, yeah, that's what they're looking for indeed.
Look at
after
those big
Old Dominion
feet.
Was down by four. Thankfully has a reserve on hand.
Yes.
That's good thinking.
He's got 6 points. Three boards on the afternoon. Only played 9 minutes in that first half, 2 points, and yet her team had a 4-point advantage at the break.
How important is Chastity Melvin? Leads her team in seven categories: scoring, rebounds, field goals made, field goal percentage, free throws made, blocks, and minutes per game. That is a big role. Maybe a cheerleader has found it. I believe she did. All right. Coming up on ESPN as we continue with our great basketball coverage today on ESPN and ESPN2 on ESPN, the 3-seed Louisiana Tech and Alabama. That game going on now over on ESPN. Then here from Dayton at 2 o'clock approximately, we'll have Arizona-UConn. Should be a great matchup, Pac-10 Big East. Tennessee-Rutgers, Florida-Duke. Wrap it up on ESPN today and tonight. We have all contact lenses in place. And they found it too, which is really good news. Wallace fires cross court. Herb may have touched it. Who's got it?
Wow.
Officials go together.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh my goodness. If she makes a coach someday, she won't be able to handle it.
It's a good thing she's on the opposite side of the floor of the officials.
Wow. Puts a lot into the game. It's great to see. What passion. 6-point ODU lead. Cheryl has been an effective quarterback of the team, but not spectacular offensively in the game. He has been distributing well. Roberts hit hard, no call. Melvin, strong rebound.
Well, ideally, you don't get Roberts the basketball at the foul line and make her dribble it. Can she do it? Yes. Is she excellent at it? No.
Lewis left wide open, misses the shot. Diaz stripped from behind. Ayla Wallace got a piece. Lewis is fouled. Uh-oh, Panichero. Zisha has got her fourth as she reaches in.
Three make that. Tisha Finisterra. That's her third personal foul, team's fourth.
Third and team's fourth, so. Andrade out. She has the four fouls. Gillespie to inbound. Fresh shot clock, Melvin. Penetration, hanging shot block from behind. Keenan got a piece of that. More Keenan, good defense. Put back, not there. Lures a hand on it. Panchero comes free. Two on one. Edlin there. Roberts joins the group. A pull up, not. Hitting it again as Panchero and Herb has the rebound. Lewis will run. The freshman splits the double team and scores off glass.
Had to go between two defenders. Never had the numbers, but the ability to create. Like a running back with no blocks right there. She did it all on her own.
9 points on 4-14 shooting. And a turnover against ODU. Kay Yao enjoys what she sees from the freshmen.
There's a lot of great freshmen around the country, and we're looking at one out of the ACC. Tanisha Lewis, all rookie performer, splits the D off the dribble, uses the glass.
To go along with 9.7 assists for Lewis already in this game. 4-point contest. Lewis battling on the floor. She's upended and pushed. That's going to be on Small. 15 foul for ODU. Here in the second half, Wendy Larry knows, Dora, she's in for a battle. This is going to go right down to some crucial possessions late in the game, especially with ODU's foul trouble.
She told us yesterday, I need to keep key people on the floor. Amber Eller-Paul is not at full strength. Her knee is swollen. We mentioned Diaz's leg. She's not at full strength.
Gillespie outside the arc. Melvin. Good feed, Herb. In close hit. Summer Herb again.
Kay Yao said she would attack the short corner with Chastity Melvin because she knows Chastity is capable of passing the basketball. She understands. And Herb has done an outstanding job making herself a nice, tall target.
Against Maine, 6.6 boards against the Penguins of Youngstown State. Herb, 10 points, 9 rebounds. Over the back there, helped tip it to Melvin. Summer Herb has come up huge for the Wolfpack in this game.
7 boards, 13 points for Herb.
Big day.
Couldn't pick a better time.
Lewis free in the baseline, a couple shot off the board again. Tanisha Lewis fears no one.
A spectacular job getting, again, different performer, but you send Tanisha Lewis down in the short corner. It's very tough to guard when you've got somebody who can use the dribble, score, and pass.
6-0 spurt here, Doris, by NC State. They've tied it again. Andrade out of the game.
The Old Dominion a little bit flatter. The emotion not there with Andrade off the basketball court.
Roberts, left low block, a spin. And a travel on Nyree Roberts. Good solid defense at Andrade.
So she can't even sit on the bench. She's behind it. Her numbers on the afternoon, 8 points and 3 of 7. It doesn't show you exactly how much of a factor she is for her club because the intensity level not there right now.
You notice the last time down the floor, Evelyn was really hand in face. Gillespie on her, the man defense very tight, trying not to let her free. Lewis trying to take this game over herself. Dips into a move, not there, and rebound comes away to ODU.
I think she thought she'd draw some contact.
There was contact, just no call.
That's like taking a wrong turn right there. She really had nowhere to go.
Small outside the arc. See how close Tanisha Lewis is on Edlin. Lewis looks a little tired. Shot clock at 7. Evelyn not free this time. Shot clock at 3. Panettiere leading shot. Never got iron, so that is a shot clock violation.
Well, you are right on the money. Lewis is exhausted.
7:13 to go. Second half. Kay Yao in the pack right there. We're tied up. Don't go away. More coming up. Old Dominion among the best in the nation, scoring points per game nearly 80. They've only got 45 here with 7:13 to go in the second half, thanks to NC State's great defense. And good play as well from our Chrysler student of the game, Kristen Gillespie from NC State. On behalf of Kristen, Chrysler is proud to donate $1,000 to the General Scholarship Fund.
Coach's daughter. Her father, a junior college coach down in Florida.
Right, she's from Tallahassee, Florida State country. NC State's foul trouble. Bates gave some good minutes in the first half. Melvin and Jones each was three. Roddy on the bench with those four personals. Ayla Wallace. Jones in the corner, back for Wallace, penetrates. Hanging there, Melvin pushed from behind before the shot. Evelyn hammered her. 16 foul for ODU here in the second half.
NC State attacking the baseline. Melvin steps from the weak side of the floor. And the recovery by Evelyn, not in time.
We saw Andrade out with a four fouls since she left. 11:06 mark. NC State a 6-0 run. Trying to make an eight, and they will, thanks to Summer Earn.
15th point of the afternoon for the sophomore, and the bench scoring continues to be a factor in this one.
Lead is two for the Pack. Keenan, not an offensive threat. At the high post, Roberts has been very well neutralized. Pass broken up, bodies all over the place. Nayla Wallace comes free. Chastity Melvin baseline is fouled by Keenan, and she earns herself a trip to the free throw line. She'll shoot two. Summer Herb has stepped up an enormous game. Look at the bench scoring, 26-2. What a domination. Wow.
Andrade set to check back in. We are under 7 minutes. And the Wolfpack can get themselves a four-point advantage if Melvin knocks down two.
Nato Diaz, the only 2 points off the bench for ODU. On one of two shooting. Keane's gonna come out. Andrade right back in. Lewis will come back in as well. Much deserved break for her. She was pretty tired, working so hard on both ends of the floor.
She was penetrating, being very active offensively, and she's got the task of guarding Aubrey Evelyn on the defensive side. So, a two-way performer.
10-0 run. North Carolina State regain a four-point lead. Buckle up, everybody. A number one seed is in definite trouble now. I thought after the big run to start the second half that they're where they wanted to be. Roberts, a bounce pass. Look at Lewis working defensively. Breaks it up and comes to Melvin, who helps up her fallen teammate.
Well, Lewis has played an outstanding game. They're the run over the last five. Teno, she's scored. She's played great defense. She's given them support on the glass.
NC State the luxury now, a very deliberate possession. Up by four. Gillespie on the near wing. Shot clock at five. Lewis, hanging shot in the paint. The freshman hits another.
13 points for the freshman. Every one of them huge.
9 rebounds, 7 assists to go with it. What a game for Tanisha Lewis. Here's Aubrey Evelyn, spots up long three. Too far, regained by Evelyn. In between the circles, they'll reset. Watch out if you're Mary Andrade. She's playing aggressively as she normally would, but she's got the four fouls. When was the last time I mentioned Roberts scoring? It's been a long time. She's been shut down. Manichero's not been a factor. Driving here, trying to change that too hard, though, on the layup. Herb is such a big body down there. It's just tough to get in her way and box her out.
She comes away with rebound number 8.
Good 1-2 punch to have both those players in at once.
Well, it is, and that's why Roberts hasn't been as effective as normally she might. She's not used to having a body as big as hers on her.
Gillespie down low from Melvin. A turnaround shot too hard. Herb a hand on the rebound.
Wow.
NC State gets it back thanks to Summer Herb, who stripped it off the hand of the ODU player down low.
She came flying through the lane. Great mobility by Herb.
Wendy Larry and Old Dominion have called a timeout with 4.5 to go. The number one seed is in a heap of trouble, down by 6. North Carolina State looking for the upset. Marcy Glennie on the left, Gianna Abralik on the right. UConn Huskies, they are next up in this game here in Dayton. They'll play Arizona, and we'll have that for you at about 2 o'clock on ESPN. 3 seed and the 2 seed to decide who plays Monday night, 5 o'clock. also to be seen on ESPN for a shot at Kansas City in this year's Final Four. It's going to be a great matchup as well. Big East and Pac-10 going head-to-head.
There, your game reset. NC State with a four and two 20s. Old Dominion with one of each. And Old Dominion already with 17 fouls, so the Wolfpack in the bonus.
What was Wendy Larry talking about, you think, with her team over there a few moments ago?
There was plenty of time. Two-possession game, no time to panic. You've got to stay solid defensively and be patient offensively. Get good looks.
Lewis, low post feed Melvin in traffic with two defenders on her, and Andrade, a strong rebound with elbows flying, coming down. Down by half a dozen. Ronnie thought about a three. Roberts, they want to get her the ball. Too hard with a left hand. Small comes free and lays it in. LaToya Small, big bucket for the Lady Monarchs.
Giving up offensive rebound is like a knife in the heart. You made Roberts shoot it with her weak hand. She can't come away with it, but then you give up an offensive board.
Something Kay Yao told us about yesterday, so crucial for NC State. Limit them to one shot. Many possessions as possible. They've done a great job of that. Defensive rebounds have been very good for NC State. Gillespie open. A couple bounces and a shot too hard. Could see she lacked the confidence when she put that one up. Kind of a grimace as she released it. Panichero driving the other way. Ronnie will reset the offense.
Good recognition there. Panichero didn't have anything. Andrade recognizes.
Shot clock sliced in half. Another very slow possession here for ODU. Roberts battling with Irv. She's just a lot bigger than Nyree Roberts. Three-pointer out there, and Irv a strong rebound. Fires the outlet pass. Michelle Jones with Panichero. Wow. She gets the ball and apparently her fourth foul at the same time. Now it's officially four on Tisha Panichero.
Huge rebound by Summer Irv, and I think she's made Nyree Roberts a little bit tired by being a body on her. Then she sees the recognition by Wallace to get out in the open floor, or by Jones. And Irv, yes, good job, teammate, good job.
6'6 sophomore forward from Lakewood, Ohio. That's in the Cleveland area, not too far from here either, so she's got plenty of friends and family in the stands watching this one, and boy, they're in for a treat, huh? Jones, big free throw. Too hard, back iron.
And just a thought here. North Carolina State has struggled with free throw shooting. They lost a game in North Carolina because they went 5 of 15 from the foul line. It hasn't been a factor in their first two NCAA games. It might become a factor.
Panichero fires out on driving three-pointer. Nails it.
Two. He's giving her a two.
Oh, there's a two.
Nine.
Yep. One toe on the strike. Two-pointer makes it a two-point game.
And if Andrade shoots consistently from the outside, this Old Dominion team is so tough.
Every possession crucial. NC State keeping its composure offensively against the aggressive defense has been very impressive. Irv again gets the feed from Melvin and hits another.
So confident. You step between the lines, you better believe you can play. Summer Irv now has 17 points, 9 boards, and gives her team a 4-point advantage.
Roberts, bounce pass down low. And she travel again.
And see what, they've made the adjustment, NC State. They came out of the second half, and they have forced Wendy Larry's Nyree Roberts to shoot the basketball. They jump to her right shoulder, and you can see she doesn't want to shoot it if you make her go to the right.
That is great coaching. 6'3", senior center from Jersey City, New Jersey, has been neutralized all game long. Does have 10 points. 4 of 9 from the floor, and it looks like Gillespie barely got the timeout at 20. With 1:34 to go in regulation.
That's why it's so important to have timeouts coming down the stretch of the ball game, and you can see the coach's daughter, Gillespie, recognizes she's in trouble, got herself in a trap in the corner. They had the 20 to blow, so she uses it. And now, with 18 on the shot clock, you can go ahead, or 10 on the shot clock, excuse me, you can go ahead and set your shot, because they were in trouble anyway, so that's a good timeout.
NC State blasted in the first round of the ACC tournament by Maryland. They said, according to Coach Yao, it was the worst game they had played in weeks, if not for the whole season. Awful appearance for them. They took some time off after the ACC tourney in Charlotte, regrouped, and boy, did they rebound in the NCAA tournament. Two games at Reynolds Coliseum, a couple of easy wins, and now a buck 34 for upsetting the number one seed here in the East.
And you can put a phenomenal amount of pressure on Old Dominion if you score here.
Big shot, Lewis not there. Comes
pull it.
Jones.
Pull it, use some clock.
Wisely done. Big offensive rebound, and that has been a huge story. Rebounding in this game. Andrade down low, not nearly as big as Summer Herb, who has matched her blow for blow. Roberts being neutralized and away from the ball, some shoving going on.
Intentional foul here. Looks like it's going to go against Roberts. That's
yep.
just a... that's as big a mistake as you can make.
She got frustrated, Doris, because of the physical contact. They were battling away from the ball, and she lashed out.
When you play Old Dominion, you better come with your gloves strapped on because this is a phenomenally physical team. NC State was prepared for it. They've responded to it. And we're going to show you exactly. Check this out. Right here, they're working against each other. Roberts has been frustrated on the offensive end. A little bit of a hold, and the official right there on the baseline side. I don't know. That's pretty tough to call an intentional right there. Andy Larry has cause to be upset.
So now two free throws. The intentional foul. Melvin short on the first, a crucial miss. The ball as well, so that is awfully big.
Well, it only becomes a factor if she makes a free throw, and there it is. But, you know, remember, Kay Yao said to us, I didn't want this to become a mental issue with our free throw shooting. So, you know, we don't talk about it too much. We've been solid through the first two NCAA tournament games. But, you know, that's a critical component when you come to tournament time. You've got to be able to knock down some charity stripes.
One of two on that trip to the free throw line. The senior tri-captain. Another captain here inbound. She's only a junior, but a great team leader. Gillespie.
Here's what you do. You isolate on Tisha because she's got four. And allow Lewis to break her down. She's got that capability.
Under a minute left in regulation. Trying to make the steal. 15 in the shot clock. Look at the composure from Lewis, the freshman. She glances at the shot clock, knows she's got time. Now it's down to 10 and a double team. Edlin fires out at her. Lewis tries. Hang a shot. Oh, it's blocked by Roberts. But they get the ball back.
Gotta get it up.
Long shot. Gillespie not there. And a travel call on Melvin. They avoided the shot clock violation, but now ODU gets it back down by five. The key there, though, Doris, so much time off the clock
yes.
for Old Dominion. We're down to 34.8 in the second half.
Kay uses another timeout because she wants to set her defense. I think you put some pressure on in the backcourt, take some time off the clock.
So 34.8 away from a third number one seed going down.
Score delivery pizza.
Ouch!
Minus the delivery price. For fresh delivery taste without the delivery price, it's DiGiorno.
ESPN's presentation of the NCAA Women's Basketball Tournament is brought to you by Plymouth. More fun, more car. That's Plymouth.
34.8 seconds stand between North Carolina State and a monumental upset of Old Dominion, and the emotion that must be going through the mind of Kay Yao. 23rd season at NC State. She has never won a Sweet 16 game. She's so close now, Doris.
And when I asked about it yesterday, she came very close to tears, had to compose herself.
Now just smart play from NC State. They should win this thing. Up by five.
Two-possession game, a 3-2 to tie.
Nearly stripped from behind by Gillespie.
Can't take this much time, babe. You got to get a look.
Panichero, long shot, hit!
Wow!
Three-pointer!
And they'll get a timeout.
20-second timeout called by ODU. What a huge shot. Tisha Panichero, that's why she's a two-time first-team All-America. Hits the shot right before the shot clock buzzer was about to sound.
It looks like they're taking too much time to get the look. They exchange on the screen. Melvin, not enough in her face. She allows her to get the shot off. So now you've given up the three. So now if you're Old Dominion, you've got to play solid defense. They're going to go for the steal right away. If they do commit another foul, they're the reset. NC State with one of each timeout, or Old Dominion just used their last one.
First, second half points for Panichero in this game. That's how neutralized she's been. Tanisha Lewis has been brilliant for NC State, but the job is not done. 17.7 left, second half. Full court pressure.
You've got to go for the steal, and if you don't get it, you got to hit.
Gillespie in the backcourt. She's a solid free throw shooter. So is Melvin. Fires for Herb. Nearly falls out of bounds. Gets the ball away, Gillespie.
You don't even have to take a shot. That's right. You had a hitter. They used a lot of time. There was 17 on the clock. They used a full 10 before they got the foul. Well, we've talked about a free throw shooting.
Wow. It all comes down to this. The transfer from Auburn. Kristen Gillespie, the coach's daughters we've talked about, from Tallahassee, Florida, and on the ODU bench. Shock, disbelief at this point. To be down by a bucket, 7.1 left.
Gillespie is the second cousin of Terry Gannon. Great player at NC State, and when she was unhappy at Auburn, it was Terry Gannon who initiated the contact with Kay Yao and brought her to the Wolfpack.
It's the first.
That's
wears the same jersey number as Terry Gannon, in fact, number 24. This to seal the deal. Oh, it rattles out.
Need the three. Got to check Panichero. There's
after
the foul.
5 seconds, a foul call on Lachelle Jones.
They if had him to give.
Limit, right.
They had him to give. That's great coaching. You had him to give. You just got to be careful not to get the intentional call. But they've got two more, only five team fouls. You can make it very tough for Old Dominion to get a shot off if you continue to do that.
Watch number 12, Evelyn. She's dangerous. We know Panichero, of course, can bury a three. 3.7 left. She can't find anyone to pass to. Diaz fires it short. Followed in. It's not going to be enough. 0.7 left. Fire down for it. It's over. It is over. Wolfpack by one, and Kay Yao is finally into the Elite Eight. A number one seed goes down for the third time in this tournament. NC State, the 4 seed, is through to the regional final. Our Nike player of the game, Summer Irv. What a day she had off the Wolfpack bench. 17 points, 8 of 12 from the floor, and 9 huge rebounds. She neutralized Nyree Roberts all day. For Wendy Larry, the legendary coach at ODU, better luck for her next year. Andrade's career, a difficult turn. So our final, as Panichero's brilliant career comes to an end, 55-54 for Doris Burke. This is Dave Ryan saying so long. 12 hours of Sebringer next. It's been a presentation of ESPN2, the worldwide leader in sports. Now to the studio and Robin Roberts.
Wow, how many times do we have to say this? Anything can happen. The third time a number one seed has gone out in this tournament. NC State, for the first time ever under Kay Yao, first time ever, period, on to the Elite Eight. They will await the winner between Arizona and Connecticut. You can see that game at 2 o'clock Eastern on ESPN. And again, a fantastic finish. You know, NC State has never been this far, but they really showed how poised they were, especially at the end of that game.
Not only at the end of the game, but throughout the game. Mm-hmm. They played an excellent game, but I'll tell you what, their end of game management was incredible, both clock management and play management. They used the clock when they had to offensively, then at the end, to foul Tisha Panichero with the 3 seconds to go, rather than let them set something up. They were much more vulnerable on a quick hit than they were with Old Dominion coming out, setting something up.
And we talked before this game that fouls and officiating could play a part in it. Well, Old Dominion is up with 11 minutes to go when Mary Andrade gets her fourth foul. She is forced to sit down. Summer Herb comes in, plays great. She has 17 points. She averages 8 on the season. So that was a big, big change in the game right there.
And this will be the first time in the history of the NCAA Women's Tournament that fewer than 2 top seeds will go on to the Elite Eight. Top-seeded Tennessee, the only top seed left. 12 hours of Sebring coming up next at 2:30. Notre Dame and Purdue right here on the Deuce.